Operational report. Submarines detected. Repairs complete. Another freaking collision. Spotting report. Spotting report. Crash. Spotting report. Kill credit. Spotting report. Supplies moved. Base moved. Repairs impossible. Repairs complete. Promotions. Upgrade. Two planes in the aircraft in the pool. Okay, so the collision check. First things first, take care of the collision. I think, yeah, it's this one. 223? Oh, these clowns. At least it's an empty. It's an empty ship, I think. Okay, we'll take this mozo out of here. Return him to Manila for repair. There was also another damaged ship. Who's the other one? Is it the Ingraham? Looks like, eh? Okay. Check for damage. Of course it goes to the wrong sort. Idiots. Oh, Sharina. It's the Sharina that was hit. Well, the Sharina is still making 12 knots. Ingraham, I'll also send over to Manila for repair. And one more for Sharina. Where's the Sharina? Oh, for God's sakes. For the love of God. Why is it so god-awful difficult finding a damaged ship here? You schmucks. Okay. So we're breaking them up. That's the collision. Let's do a submarine check. All that hassle for one stupid collision. Good grief. Gunnel! Okay, these guys are heading back in. Gunnel, Finback, Ling, Tuna. We're going to have to call Lionfish, Pilotfish, Atuli, and Totog back for refueling. At Kobe, we have two damaged submarines. Quick repairs. Quick repairs. Two to go out, both for Chiba Station. The convoy from Singapore has arrived. World Dock, thank you for making me click it twice. Stupid piece of garbage. We'll dock, unload, and then I'll guess I'll get in line and go to the United States for no supplies. Okay, so the Singapore convoy heads for the States after it unloads. Here are the other convoys. Tankers are here. Okay, we'll join. Thank you. Tankers are here. Why is when I click on this thing, it always shows the wrong one? Christ. Transfer the other tankers in. And here's another. Okay. There's five tankers here. Oh, sorry, these are AOs. These are AOs that are loading these transports. They've arrived, refueled, disband. Try to repair something. Here are the escorts coming. And another bunch of transports coming. Quiet on Napari, quiet on Okinawa. No tankers on Kyushu. Actually, there are tankers, but they're already unloaded and waiting. Back up to 600. Well, close to 600. Close to 600. Bet you a dollar to a donut, it'll be back down to 200 next turn. The first thing I should concentrate over in the center is actually this base, because it's the most important thing that we have to do, right? get the base up. The base expanded by 9% last turn. And you gotta ask me, what the hell? I turned off the fortifications and I removed some of the engineers. Packed them up, ready to go. And we built 9% instead of the pissant 5 and 6%? Are you kidding me? I take engineers out and we build and the base builds more quickly? Are you stupid? Yeah, obviously the game is. Okay, well, if that's the case, I'm going to try to take out a few more engineers. If I can, I'm going to do just remove them. Move them up to the north, maybe work on Nagaoka. I'm going to take the ones that we can leave in one day. That's right. We'll take the ones that can pack and load in one day, and I'm sending them up to Nagaoka. Okay, so I packed up a few more engineers, sending them up north, a few more that can load and leave in one day. It sounds as stupid as it is, right? You take engineers out and you build the base faster. It just staggers the imagination to think that that's what's happening here. PT boats, we're on patrol here, but nobody's bombing us. Nobody's trying the kamikaze route. Here, the battleships were attacked by kamikazes. Well, we're nothing else to do. Just sit here and take it. Take it. There's nowhere to go. We can't get into Shimizu. We can't get to Yokohama. And to get to Yokohama, we gotta have Shimizu. All right, we're into the tank destroyer battalion. We probed it. See, we've gone in. We've won that hex side. Now let's get the hell out of here. Oh, boy. We've got this one physically surrounded. Not the red. There's still a red hex side here. Red hex side here. Red hex side here. So the units here, the 79 units, could go back into Tokyo. Could go to the east. Could go to the northwest or the southwest. So I'm trying to win all these hex sides. I've got an anti-aircraft unit here. Where is it? Moving down. Moving five a day. Are you freaking kidding me? Oh, for God's sakes. But it's moving. At least it's moving. It's moving five per day, so in 2 weeks, it'll be down here, and it'll seal off the northwest, and the AI won't be able to come in, won't be able to invade Nagano from Maybashi. I don't know if it wants to, but I don't want to give it the option. We had a bombardment attack here, and no real casualties. We'll take it. A pathetic, minor amount of fatigue, disruption, minor. So we're still marching to the northeast. Now, can anybody tell me how far these marched? Right? Can anyone tell me how far the artillery's marched? No. Oh, the solution! Click on every one of them! Yep. Click on every one of them. It's nice to see that we've marched 15. Okay, the artillery's marched 15 under combat mode. The infantry, you know, they've also marched 15, so I'm really kind of happy. They're marching at the same time. I hope they're marching at the same time. I mean, there might be some units in here that are only marching 10 or 12. I don't know. Unless you go and click on every one of them. And I sure as hell ain't going to do that. Stupid, right? No way am I going to march, click through every single artillery unit to find out if he's marching 15 or not. Idiocy. But if they are all marching 15 per day, in 4 days, or in 3 more days, they'll be up here. Which is great. Because then we'll crush this thing and be ready to either march back in here or move elsewhere. Okay, so 3 days to get out of here. Let's see, and if the AI attacks us, we will be in combat mode, so we're not going to. I don't need to put them into reserve mode, and risk missing out on combat. Remember, if you're in reserve mode, you can certainly. The penalty is that if you're attacked and the unit is in reserve mode, the unit may or may not reactivate and jump into the attack. But at least if it does jump into the attack, it's not penalized. Whereas if you put it in movement mode, and you try to jump into the, and you're attacked, you can suffer a mode penalty, where you're all packed up in road transit. So the good part is they're all moving at 15 miles an hour, and they should all leave the hex, should all leave the hex at the same time. The armor unit that came in here is wonderful. It arrived in one day. Now I want to send it out to the west. Why? Because I want to do the same thing I'm doing over here. By probing it and coming in one, by using the tank destroyer unit and coming in, I am preventing the AI from coming out this direction. And I can, even though the AI knows I'm here, holy cow, 226 units, even though the AI knows that the unit's here, and if it was to say, oh, launch a deliberate attack or deliberate or shock attack or any attack, I won't, the units move before the con before attacks are conducted. So I'm going to be in and out before the enemy can even land a barrage. That's what I want to be doing with the tank unit when I move it out to the west here. We'll just be probing, 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 keeping the enemy from, the enemy won't be able to attack it, but also the enemy won't be able to move to the west. And I want to, and that, and I want to be, what's the term? Funneling or channeling or trying to control the movement of the enemy as best I can. We've got infantry units moving out of here. Base force has arrived. Oh, it upgraded as well. Base force has arrived. This is the 48. I need 40 garrison here. This is your 40 garrison. At Nagaoka, the AI has just been peppering us with artillery. Let's see. We have armor here. Let's make sure all the armor's in reserve. Why do I say that? Okay, this one. Well, I'm trying to upgrade this one, but it won't upgrade. Why do I want the armor in reserve? Because the infantry can replace their any losses more easily than the tanks. The tanks are just such a low production rate that I don't want to lose any to some stupid artillery barrage. So the tank, the infantry, gets to shield the tanks. Isn't that just wonderful? We have a number, we've destroyed what, 37, 45 aircraft, which is great. That's only 45 pissant points. Now the points, we aren't losing anything over here, but I could start bombing from Nagoya. I could, and then I just sacrifice all the bombers from long range. I can't cover it well with fighters. I can't escort well, and the AI will simply just, I just be throwing away good bombers and lives for nothing. Well, not for nothing. They'll get hits, but I'll be wasting the entire air force trying to. So I'm not going to bomb from a range of three. I'm waiting for a range of one. Sorry. Oh, and the enemy unit that was here seems to have vanished. But he should still be here. We hit the W control key and said, "There's appears to be some kind of unit ownership here." So the unit didn't move. We just didn't detect it. Just one enemy submarine contact near Truk. Otherwise, we're quiet in the Marianas, quiet on the Bonin. Bonin Islands, the transport, or sorry, the tender is just unloading one load of more supplies onto Hahajima before heading back to. Yeah, you know, even at the rate we're going right now, we're never going to use up, but I just keep throwing supply on here anyway. Just a good practice, I guess. Convoys moving back and forth. Tanker loading at Los Angeles, not enough fuel. Another group has returned. Refuel from the dock. No more. We sucked up all the fuel even. Oh my God, this is pathetic, isn't it? Oh, wow. Okay. Transports here are still trying to load supplies. Yeah, we've got enough. We've formed up enough. We've loaded enough. I'll take out the full ones, send them to Manila, and replace them with empties. Transports have refueled or refueled as many as they can. Now we're going to repair them. All right, all ships ready. Repair in one day or so. 25 more ships are loaded, heading for the Philippines. 25 empty ships are at Night raid on Nagano, 12 Tsurugi, 2 shot down. Night raid Nagano, 6 more Tsurugi, 2 more shot down. Japanese bombardment Maebashi. Well, we lost a few, but we also inflicted a few more. Bombardment on Nagaoka. No Allied casualties. That's just the price of admission, I guess.